A few days ago, Apple released a bunch of software updates, and that was macOS Big Sur 11.7.2, Monterey 12.6.2, and macOS Ventura 13.1. And just a few hours ago, the new Dortania Open Core Legacy Patcher 0.5.3 was released. And the question we all want to know is, can we update our unsupported Macs to 13.1 Ventura or to 12.6.2 Monterey? Let's talk about it. So the release of the macOS updates were just more bug fixing and patching security issues. So there were no new features added. But with Ventura 13.1, there was the Freeform app added to the macOS. There are a lot of pages where you can just go through all the details with the update, but what we want to know, can our unsupported Macs, and I have here a MacBook Pro 2012 and a MacBook Air 2013, below the desk is a Mac Mini 2014, and I tested the new macOS Ventura 13.1 on all three of these devices, if they can run it, if there are any issues, and what issues have been fixed since the last version 13.0.1. And what I can tell you is that all the devices took the update flawlessly. No problem at all. Just one downside is that if you see the update in macOS and you say upgrade or update the macOS, you always have to download the full nearly 12 gigabyte version of Ventura. Why is that? Because with OpenCore and the way it is enabling Ventura on your unsupported Macs, the incremental update function is broken. And so you just cannot update like a 1 or 2 gigabyte update. You have to download the whole version and then do the update. With the MacBook Pro here, I created a USB drive, like you can see here on my Ultimate tutorial with OpenCore, and I just plugged it in and booted OpenCore, obviously, and selected install macOS Ventura. And then the update shows up, like if you do a clean install or if you do an update, it all looks the same. And when you do the update, you keep your data and you can just do the update via the USB drive. On the MacBook Air, I just downloaded the file and it was in applications and I just started it and it did the update from the macOS itself. Both took about half an hour for the update. Afterwards, make sure that you check that the post-install root patch is installed again. Normally, the OpenCore Legacy Patcher just detects that you did an update and it says, okay, there was an update done, the root patch is broken, shall I apply it again? Yes, you have to, because otherwise, most probably you will lose the graphic acceleration. Talking about the OpenCore Legacy Patcher, the brand new version 0.5.3 that was just released a few hours ago is also mainly a bug fix version. And I have a sad news for all those guys, all you guys using the old cheese grater, the Mac Pro 4.1 or 5.1, it's still not supported by OpenCore for Ventura. So on my Mac Pro cheese grater, I have it down below my desk, I did the update to 12.6.2. There is just a security issue fixed and some updates, but nothing major. The update went like a charm. I think there was 3 restarts and everything worked as before. So very flawlessly, the OpenCore 0.8.7 is included into the legacy patcher, and this one is really far advanced and you should have no problems with installing the updates on your unsupported Mac. So what updates brings the 0.5.3 legacy patcher? Mainly the audio support for pre-2012 models, so 2011 and older. One issue is not fixed yet. So if you're running Ventura on an unsupported Mac and you're starting the weather app and you're scrolling down, it will crash. It crashes on the MacBook Pro 2012, on the MacBook Air 2013, and on the iMac 2014. So nobody knows what this weather app is doing that is always crashing with officially unsupported Macs. By the way, if you're planning on updating your unsupported Mac and you need a good tool to clean it up before you update, the Clean My Mac X software has a Christmas sale starting on December the 19th. You find the link for saving 30% down in the video description. And if you haven't yet, I would recommend you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for notification so you don't miss any more updates. I continue testing 0.5.3 and macOS 13.1 here on all these unsupported devices, and we're desperately waiting for the developers, and they are working on it. You see the change logs, they are working on it, bringing Ventura on the Mac Pro 5.1 on the old cheese grater. And by the way, I just recently got a Mac Pro 6.1, so the trash can from 2013, that is already supported with Ventura, with the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. So there will be some results soon when I test Ventura 13.1 and the new Legacy Patcher 0.5.3 on the new Mac Pro from 2013. Right now, have a lot of fun on my channel and see you soon. Bye bye.